Wonderful. Thank you so much, Michael. So our next guest is a performer turned author. Zach Boddicker is an award-winning author, so please welcome Zach Boddicker. Boddicker.
I'm great.
You're great.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming on.
Great to be here for the first time.
For the first time, yes. I know. And you have done like a million things before being an author, but now you're a writer, an author. So talk about your life a little bit before writing.
Well, I started playing guitar, I guess, when I was 10, and I always wanted to be in some kind of band. So I got some bands together in junior high school, and then went to college and played in some like country bands, playing guitar, and then mostly so I could go to bars underage. I'll be honest with you, I didn't really care for the material. Really.
Well, that's one way to do it. I mean, if you got to get in the bar, might as well perform it.
Oh yeah.
Did you get? I mean, you don't have to answer this on camera, but did you get any drinks and stuff?
Oh no. No, I didn't drink back then.
So you've been performing for a long, long time, and you were in a pretty famous band around these parts, right? Talk about that a little bit. Playing steel pedal.
Yeah, I joined up with a band called Drag the River right after college. Literally the day I graduated, we jumped in the truck and left for like a month, maybe, to the East Coast and back.
Yeah.
So that was an eye opener, and then I did that for about 5 years, toured with them. We did maybe 5 records during that time. Then I went to grad school, so I quit. And then after that, started a band called 4-H Royalty, which I've been writing, fronting for, I guess, 10 years now. So we've done 3 records plus 1 on the way.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So describe the music of 4-H Royalty a little bit.
It's like Midwestern rock with a little bit of jazz influence. It's getting weirder, so
it's just morphing into different things every performance.
It has to, because you know, you just got to change, you got to evolve.
Yeah,
if you don't change your mind sometime, you may as well be dead, you know. It's the quote.
So you've performed for many years, and now you're an author.
Yeah.
And you have written this fantastic book, The Essential Carl, am I saying the last name right? Mahoney?
Mahogany.
Mahogany.
Yeah.
I can't read, apparently. So talk about the book, Carl Mahogany.
Well, it just came out on Last Chance Press it's kind of a nomadic group of artists and architects and writers and stuff that started a press. So that came out like a couple months ago, and it's been doing pretty well. Done quite a few readings. And
yeah.
I try to do like a reading and then a, you know, 3 or 4 song performance.
So just give like a brief kind of synopsis of the book. No spoilers or anything.
No spoilers. Okay. Well, it's about a former recovering Nashville professional songwriter.
Okay.
Who finds himself in Eastern Colorado, and just trying to get his life together, get a second act put together, but the locals have other plans for him.
Oh no!
So, he's being forced to go out on tour to support an album that he doesn't approve of.
Okay.
So, but, you know, at least a third of the book is spent on the road, where he's visiting old friends and people are coming out of the woodwork that
is he any didn't expect. Of your experience on the road kind of bleeding into his experience on the road?
Just some general stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, fortunately, I haven't had to live through most of what happens in there. So I'm grateful for that every day.
And what kind of motivated you to get into writing in the first place? Because you performed for so long, this is kind of a new chapter in your life.
I just enjoy longer work and longer pieces. You know, songs are a limit. So, you know, 3-4 minute songs kind of a limit. And it's good for its own thing, but if just to really stretch out and, you know, get complicated without writing a song cycle or something like that. So anyway, I really enjoy it, and I've got my second book on the way.
You're already working on it?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you give us any hints of what that might look? Is it a sequel or a whole different story?
It's not, definitely not a sequel. There might be some tie-ins, but they're going to be real vague.
Okay.
So.
And then when this becomes a movie someday, are you going to do the music for the movie?
If they ask me, I bet they'll farm it out to somebody else. Yeah, I don't know. I've got, you know, I actually thought about putting a CD out with this, like
okay.
a companion piece, and we may still do that.
Yeah.
With the song I'm going to play later, and then you know a few others that I kind of wrote, kind of based on the book, but not really.
I love that idea of like having that CD with it. So what would that look like? Would you solely work on that, or who all would contribute?
I'd probably write all the songs and do the guitar and vocals, maybe pedal steel, but I'd get other people that actually know how to play drums and other instruments to do the rest.
And talk about the pedal steel for a moment, because I love that instrument, and it's so cool that you played it for so long. So describe what it is.
Oh, man, where to start? It's it's called the Hillbilly Helicopter, the Drunk Piano. It's just a really complicated harp, I guess. And if you're not familiar what it sounds like, just put on some old country music country music before, say, the year 2000, and you'll hear it prominently. You don't hear it as much anymore on pop country radio, but it's still out there. A lot of people playing it now. From when I started playing around here, there weren't really that many.
Okay.
You see a lot more interest in it now, so that's good.
And you're going to do one song for us today, so talk about that a little bit.
It's a kind of a leaving home song, leaving a small town song, which sounds like it's been done a million times, and it has. But, you know, I like to kind of take a trite cliche kind of thing and try to, you know, turn on its head, do something else with it.
Exactly.
And I kind of imagined it as a song that maybe Carl would have written for somebody, you know, for somebody else to perform.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much for coming on.
All right,
I can't wait to hear you perform. And everyone else should stick around so they can hear you perform as well. Cool. All right.
Before you slip into unconsciousness, I'd like to have another kiss, another.